So, hello again. Nice to see you. Bit subliminal. So, what I'm putting up today is try and shake things up a bit. Because I can't understand why I'm not getting any cease and desist letters. Why are they not coming back and going, stop saying what you're saying? This is all wrong. And getting heavy letters from the solicitors and things like that. I don't know. I would have expected by now that I would have got a few letters or some correspondence about something, but absolutely nothing. So now what we've got is, what we're going to do now is, I think, and this really, I'm putting this video out, not really to my customers, I'm not putting this video out to anybody else apart from the Royal Mint employees that I know are watching the videos. We now have Royal Mint top brass watching our videos. We've got Ian Glenn watching our videos. There's Mr. McDade watching our videos. There's the Lady Jessop watching our videos. There is Chris Inson, Head of Legal, watching our videos, and so on. So we've got you all watching our videos, and we've got the Royal Experience, Royal Mint Experience Shop watching our videos, and we've got Royal Mint staff watching our videos. So this is a direct appeal to Royal Mint staff. Some of you know that what's going on is not legal. Some of you know this. Some of you are carrying on, carrying out instructions that you know are not strictly correct. And so what I'm doing is I'm putting up £10,000 worth of goods. So that's 1 million reward points, right? 1 million reward points is a genuine offer. £10,000 in stock to anybody that wants to come forward and give us the information that will lead to the arrest and conviction, prosecution, arrest, prosecution, and conviction of Mr. McDade, Mr. Inson, the Lady Jessop, or Ian Glenn of 288 Group. Because we've also got Change Checker staff watching as well. Now, you know. A lot of what's been going on has been wrong and illegal. And so this is what I'm doing. So in order to publicise this a little bit, here, for example, is Ian Glenn. Most wanted. Reward. And you can get that on a t-shirt. And you can get that on. That's a pretty cool design, I thought. Look at that for an all-over design. That's pretty cool. In fact, if I was Ian Glenn, I'd be really impressed by that. And then you can get it on a mug. So, I'm not just being silly, I am being silly. But there's a hoodie. I am be, and it's got a TGBCH logo on the back. So when you go on the back of the shirt, you've got that on the back of the hoodie. There we have him on a t-shirt. And then we have on the back of the t-shirt, because it's us that's setting the reward, you pardon me. So then we can go to things like, let's have a look at the Lady Jessop. We've got the Lady Jessop on a pair of socks, which I thought was quite cool. There's a really cool all over design there. And then there's a, where's the mug? Oh, look, there's a sweatshirt. Make them famous. And then on the mug, you got that. And then, of course, on the other side in the mug, same applies to all of them. You got that. You see? So you get that on one side. And then on the other side, you get their picture and the most wanted. right? So 1 million reward points for anyone that can come forward with information that will lead to the arrest, prosecution and conviction of all the above. This is a, pardon me, this is a private citizens. I'm hoping, you know, I get the information that will enable me to go down there. Wouldn't it be fantastic if I could go down there live, turn up, knock on the door, knock, 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 and make a citizen's arrest? Now that would be something, you know, they'd be right, they'd be doing a film about that. How about Mr. McDade on a pair of socks? And then you can walk all over him like he walks all over us. Or you could get his pretty face on a mug and then have the Royal Mafia on the other side of the mug. That's pretty cool, isn't it? So there's those kinds of designs as well. And all of this is done in fun and jest and seriousness over highlighting these issues. And why am I making such a big deal of it? I'm making such a big deal of it because the Royal Mint statement, official statement, says they buy them back from the Treasury, they supplement their own tills at their own expense, and they get them from the banks. So they get them, they buy them back from the Treasury, they get them from the banks, and they supplement their tills with what they make themselves. Now, buying back from the Treasury, there needs to be some kind of proof of that, some kind of receipt. It's a public-owned company. Supplementing them and putting them in their tills means making more, and the Royal Mint have now officially stated that the official statement was wrong, and they're now saying we did not use the word supplement our tills. We didn't use the word supplement. They did. So they're backtracking on the original statement that they made, and the original statement says they made them themselves and put them in the tills. And then, of course, you've got the problem about them saying that they get them from the banks like everybody else. Now, how can they get them from the banks like everybody else if they were only delivered to the post offices? These are questions that need answering. Otherwise, you know, it just becomes a case of doing business and saying any old crap that you want to say. A bit like, no, I mean, how different is it to the 350 million on the side of a bus that we all heard about with the Brexit and all the rest of it? There's no difference. It's like, on the one hand, the politicians are allowed to just say whatever they want and not back it up and not come through with their promises. And it seems like business is getting more like that. It's, you know, business is being able to say what it wants and it doesn't really matter. And I think it's wrong. And I think it's wrong the way that they're doing it, because it's all illegal and it's all undercover and it's all under the table, you know, without any checks and balances. If there was checks and balances, then we wouldn't have been going on like this for 2 years. And at some point over the last 6 months that I've been bleating on about the 10Ps over and over again, at some point somebody would have arranged a meeting with us. Somebody would have sat down with us. Somebody would have talked to us over the phone and said, Ian, look, sorry, mate, you got it all wrong. You know, it's easy to get things wrong. I'll be the first person to say that. But then you have a conversation with somebody and they go, yeah, you got it all wrong. It's this, it's that, it's this, it's that. Oh, okay, sorry. But none of that is happening. It's all running for cover and changing policies and changing rules and nobody actually coming forward and telling the truth. So this is why I think that we have gotten 100%. All we need is the money to get it all the way. We raise the money to get it all the way and we've gotten beat. Because there is no way they can come out of it. I put a £5,000 challenge up and nobody has won that. Why is that? If everything is so above board, why has nobody won that? So my appeal to all the staff is, you know, you are borderline doing stuff that you shouldn't really be doing. There's stuff going on where you're working that really, you know, I say should, you could be putting your hand up and going, no, I'm not doing that. I'm not doing that because what you're asking me to do is illegal. And maybe you're too frightened of losing your jobs, and I get that too. So maybe someone wants to contact me in confidence. Because if it's in confidence and you're contacting me and you're being honest, I'm not going to share the information publicly. I'm not going to do that to you. I'm not going to record the conversation and make it public if I'm dealing with somebody that's straight. I just don't like dealing with people that are not straight. And I put the last recording up because I was promised a phone call back. You heard it on the recording. Promised a phone call back by 4 o'clock, and I waited 24 hours. Didn't get a phone call, so I put a video up. So we've got them running for cover. Why don't you come and support us? Get 10 times your money, 10 times your money investment if you come over and buy that off our website. Or you can do the crowdfunding on our website. Just go to the top of the page, look for the crowdfunding link. Or go to our merchandising and have a bit of fun. And if you have any of these merchandising things off our merchandising site, please send us a video with you wearing it or using it. And I'm going to clip those videos together and make a little video of different people that are using our products. And you'll get a mention. So if you've got a business, if you've got a Facebook page or a business and you want it mentioned, buy a product, send me the video of you using the product, and I'll put it all together and I'll use the clips. All right, thanks very much. Please support us. And if you're working at the Royal Mint or 288 Group and you maybe are getting a bit fed up with the lies that you're being told to tell and one thing and another, maybe you'd like to get in touch. £10,000 worth up for grabs. And if that doesn't twist anybody's arm, I might increase it and keep increasing it until it does. £10,000 to the first person that comes forward. Not just every one of you, the first person that comes forward, 10 grand. You come forward and help us out here. Let's have some inside information of what's going on down there, because we know it's wrong, you know it's wrong, so let's get together. This has been Ian, www.thegreatbritishcoinhunt.com.